And now the fourth project is Barcode Studio. Barcode Studio is an independent Java application for generating and printing multiple barcodes using databases or on user-defined label and fields. So interns, please proceed with your presentation.
Good evening, everyone. I am Preeti Agrawal, along with Renu and Vinisha. We are the team members of the project Barcode Studio. What is actually our project? The purpose of Barcode Studio is to produce multiple barcodes on a particular label that can be whose shape, size, style can be modified according to the needs of the user. Further, what was the motivation of developing such a project or such a software? There are different proprietary softwares available which are tightly bound and not open source. Means user cannot these softwares are not freely available to the user. But our software, it is open source and will be freely available to the user. Next is customized labels, customized barcode stickers. Barcode stickers can be customized according to the needs of the user. He can resize the barcode directly by drag and drop. He has to, all the thing will be dynamic in our project. Now third, there is no single platform that can support multiple barcodes. Means code 128, code 39, etc. There are many barcodes which our platform can support, but there is no software till date that can support different barcodes. Further, multiple copies of the same barcode. Means in our software we can have single barcode, single barcode, multiple barcode, single copy, and multiple barcode, multiple copy. Means all the possible mapping we can have in our software. Now moving further, what are the technologies that has been used in our software? First, it is a Java application. Second, the database is maintained in MySQL. The offline database, why it is needed, we will tell you later. It is maintained using SQLite. Then different libraries we have to add for barcode and PDF, like Zsync and iText PDF, etc. Now further moving to the next slide. What are the benefits of our project? It is cost effective. Means that when we take out the printout in a particular label, then it will save a lot of paper and it will be much more cost effective. Means lot of amount of cost will not be, means very cheaply we can produce the multiple barcodes. Second, we can have customized stickers and barcodes, captions, all will be dynamically resized and reshaped according to the needs of user. Then, now further, already I have told you that different kinds of mapping are possible in our project, such that we can have single barcode, single copy, the multiple barcodes, multiple copies. User can, if there is a list of, in the database table, there are list of values available. If he want first value and last value only to be printed, then he has the option of that also. He has to not print all the values, only selected values according to his own need. Now further, in brief, I will describe my software and its features. First, what the user has to do, he has to create a custom label in which he can have his own page setting, label border, means many features we have provided in the page setting page. Across the down the across page setting also he can give at the time of printing the barcode. Then, from where he will get the value that will actually appear on the barcode. He has two options. First, he can do the database connectivity, or second, he can directly input the value and get the result. Suppose I don't know anything about computer science, but I want to generate the barcode for my name. Then what I will do, directly I will enter my name and I can generate the barcode. No database connectivity, nothing is required. Then further, the user will get a print preview of what actually the barcode, for what data he want to barcode to be printed. He will get a print preview of that. And finally, he can take the printout of the print preview. Either he can export it to the PDF or he can directly give the print command, attach the barcode printer, and he will take the printout of the barcodes. Now we will show the demonstration of our project. This is the first frame that actually appears. But as already I have told you, user will create a new label on which the barcodes will appear. He has to give the custom setting, so he will select the custom label and proceed with the next button. On clicking next, a page setting window appears where he can give the page format according to his requirement. The select scale allows the user to select any scale. He can give the values in inches, centimeter according to his requirement. He can change all the settings that we have given. He can change according to his requirement. And he can save that setting also, that will be permanently saved, so that when next time user comes, he will have that setting that he has already saved. So it is completely dynamic. Now the border, you might see the label, it is checked. It shows that when we will take the printout of barcode, each barcode can have the borders. If he unselects, then the border will not appear. And two options, like print order across and down, and down the across, means in which order he wants to view the barcode. Now he can see the preview with the dummy value. Now here in this page, we are showing the dummy value, so that here only he can do any modification. Further also we will show the print preview, but from starting he has to again come back. So here a small print preview dummy we are showing. Now he will click on finish. Now the window appears in which he will actually design how his barcode after it will be printed on label will look like. He has to do database connectivity, where he will log in, username and password he has to give. We can connect to any PC of yours also, by if you give IP address and all. Then list of database will be shown. Suppose I want to connect student database, then you are connected to the database. Now in the combo box there is a data field. If you want to add any caption, that will appear below your barcode, what information it contains, then you can add the caption. This is the barcode, different barcodes are available. So the most commonly used code 128, suppose I am selecting, and I can reshape, move anywhere what the user wants. Then we can also change the setting of the text that will appear as a caption. Suppose we go for Arial only, let it be Arial only. Then plain text, it can be bold, anything you can do. And size also you can do 10, anything. Now when the user clicks on the caption, double click on caption, then a pop-up window comes in which he will select the table for which he wants to actually generate the barcode. Suppose I go for codes, details, anything. Suppose barcode is a column name is the barcode. Click on barcodes and click on OK. Then the first value of that particular column appears here. Now the user can view the print preview. Not print preview exactly. Now he will select the data for which he wants to develop, generate the barcode. He can select all or only certain data, scroll it up and down. He can select only certain data for which he want to generate barcode. He can uncheck, check anything. And also number of times he can specify. Suppose first record I want to print 10 times, 5 times, anything you can write. Similarly, you can change all the other values. And click on the preview button, click. Then a preview of the barcode that you have designed with different values and multiple pages are available. You can export it to the PDF, click on export to PDF. Just you have to write the name of your PDF file and it will be saved. Anything right? Okay. And you, a user can directly print also if the printer is attached. Now there is no printer, so cancel it. Close. Now, second, I told you that directly user can also enter the text. So double click if I don't want to connect to database and anything I don't want to do. Simply you write anything, intern 001 suppose, any value you can write. Insert intern 001. Two records, let us check. Insert. Now here also user has a facility to change number of times he want to print certain records. He can change that and click on OK button. Directly the print preview will be shown to the user. There is only one page, so, and here same, no need to do. Here again he has same option, print and export to PDF. Now close it. There a small report is also, we are generating a small report also on the site back of which database user has selected. This is the offline database we are maintaining using the SQLite. This is the list. Just now we have entered what steps we have done are also listed here along with the time, date, etc. You can delete any of the record if you want, then close. And further a help menu is provided where the user can go through how actually to use our software. And thank you. And we not only developed the software, we have also started implementing. First implementation was Wikipedia Hackathon. We had the barcode sticker that was printed by our printer only, and we did it. So thank you.
Specification. No, where did you get the specifications of your system? Specifications of what you are developing.
Hello.
How?
Hello.
So all the screens were given by him.
What screens they have developed?
Requirements. Requirements means what?
Suppose if there is small product and we want the barcode for that.
Where did you get the requirements from? Exactly. So that is what I want.
No, connect.
Correct.
That was the reference.
Exactly.
1 mile ahead also.
Right. So you took a proprietary, that's for everybody. So you took a proprietary software, okay, analyzed it, and then whatever features you wanted to add, you added. Okay. Whatever. You thought something. Okay. Now generally there's supposed to be a business expert who does that. Okay. In the absence of the business expert, how do I know that the features you added are actually usable by the industry? Well, sounds very good.
Okay. Correct.
No, but no, that mile ahead the industry may not need.
No.
That's what I'm saying.
Flexibility what they have.
No, they have to justify why they have gone miles ahead. No.
Miles ahead is the reason that we are using the bus. Those were the requirements of ours. Yes, along with
So you are the business user,
yes.
And you felt that the current proprietary software which you are using is not serving your needs.
30-day limitation
software available. 30 days has got nothing to do with it. 30 days you don't want to pay.